Hello everybody, in this video we'll start with numerical integration. So let us see, why do we need this numerical integration? Suppose you have this integral, definite integral, e raised to power x dx, 0 to 1. Very easily you can compute this integral, because you know that integration of e raised to power x is e raised to power x, and your limits are from 0 to 1. So you'll put e raised to power 1 minus e raised to power 0, you know this is equal to e minus 1. But suppose I give you some integral like this. You have tan inverse of x plus 1 e raised to power x square plus 2 sine of 2x plus 7 dx, 0 to 1. So you have a very complicated integrand here, so you may not be able to find out the integral in a nice way as we have done in the first example, right? Okay, so we are sad that we are not able to find out anything which can actually give us the solution to this integral. Okay, then we have a savior, that is numerical analysis. So numerical analysis comes and saves us, and it tells us that okay, I may not be able to give you the exact value of this integral, but I can give you an approximate value of this integral. So you have to note that this integral is actually a number, right? So numerical analysis will give us an approximate value of this integral, right? So we say okay, something is better than nothing, so we are happy that we are at least getting an approximate value, right? So let us see how we are doing it. So we'll consider this function, integral a to b f of x dx, right? Suppose this is the integral which we want to compute, and somehow we are not able to compute it with usual mathematical techniques, right? Okay, so idea is, okay, this function is complicated. Can you replace this function with some simple function whose integration you know, right? So idea is, you approximate your function fx with a function whose integral is known to you, right? So what is the best choice? So we know that polynomials, these are our favorite functions. So we would like to approximate our function f of x with the polynomial function, right? And then we will integrate that polynomial function, right? And now we have many ways to approximate a function with a polynomial function, depending on how many nodes you are using, right? So we are starting with first numerical integration technique, that is called trapezoidal rule. In this trapezoidal rule, what we do, okay, I'll explain geometrically. You want to actually find out this integral a to b fx dx. So basically this is nothing but area under the curve. Suppose this is the function f of x, blue line, right? So this is the integral you are trying to find out, whole integral, right? Whole area, this whole area you want to compute, but you are not able to compute it, right? So what we do, we say that okay, you cannot compute this area. What you do, you just look at the endpoints. You have these two endpoints. You have this point as a comma f of a, and this point as b comma f of b. Just draw a straight line here, and then you compute this area which is below this straight line. So because straight line is simple, so you may be able to compute this area. So we say that okay, this much will be the error, this part will be your error, but you can approximate this area with this area, that is a purple line, purple area which I have computed, right? So what we will do, we will approximate our function with equation of a straight line joining the points a comma f of a and b comma f of b. We can simply write this equation as equation of straight line passing through two points is quite simple. We can just write the equation. Equation is given by y minus, you can choose any point, fb upon x minus b, then you have fb minus fa upon b minus a. Okay, so if you have any problem, you can go back to geometry and you can look at how to write the equation of a line when you know two points on that line, right? From here you will get y is equal to fb plus x minus b upon b minus a f of b minus f of a. So there is no problem, you replace your function with this nice polynomial, right? Okay, there is no problem, you can do like this. But because we are going to generalize whatever we are studying here, so we, instead of using this approach here, we are writing the equation of the line, we will use the Lagrange interpolating polynomials. So what are Lagrange interpolating polynomials? So Lagrange interpolating polynomials are basically, suppose you have these n plus 1 data points. For example, in the last case we had two data points, x a comma f b f of a and b comma f b. Similarly, suppose you have n plus 1 data points, x0 comma f of x0, x1 comma f of x1, xn comma f of xn, and you want to approximate the underlining f of x. So you just have data, you don't have fx, you want to approximate your function with a polynomial function, and Lagrange gives you a polynomial which is of degree at most n. So if you have n plus 1 data points, you will be having a unique polynomial of degree at most n passing through these n plus 1 data points. And what is the formula given by Lagrange for that polynomial? This formula is quite simple. What you do, you write, you have first data point, so you will have f of x naught, then you have second data point f of x1 and so on up to f of xn. So you have f of x naught, some coefficient of f of x naught, then some coefficient of f of x1, and then some coefficient of f of xn. So I'm just telling you how to write the polynomial. Lagrange interpolation will be covered in a separate video where we will derive this formula, right? And what is this polynomial? This is just when you are writing x naught, you just miss the x naught in the numerator, so you have x minus x1, x minus x2, x minus xn, and in the denominator just replace your x with x naught, so you have x naught minus x1, x naught minus x2, and x naught minus xn. And when you are writing the coefficient of fx1, then you remove x1, x minus x1 in the numerator, so you have x minus x0, x minus x2, x minus xn, and in the denominator you will have x1 minus x0, x1 minus x2, x1 minus xn. So just replace your x with x1. And similarly, in the last, when you write the coefficient f of xn, you just miss the term x minus xn in the numerator, and in the denominator you replace x with xn. So this is how you write a polynomial of degree at most n passing through n plus 1 data points using Lagrange technique, right? And Lagrange not only tells us the polynomial, but it also tells us how much is the error introduced, right? So what do you mean by error? Actually, what you are doing, you are given a function, not exactly the function, you are given the data points which are actually of some function, and you want to approximate that function with a polynomial px which is given by this formula. Then Lagrange tells you that what will be this bound, this error, fx minus px is actually fn plus 1, fn plus 1 is derivative at r divided by n plus 1 factorial, where n plus 1 is the number of data points x minus x0, x minus xn, where r is any number between the interval between x0 and xn. So this is just for this portion. Actually, we have a full video, right? You can just go back to that video and you can refer, right? Okay, so come back to our problem. What we were doing, trapezoidal rule, we had these two data points. So if we go to the according to Lagrange technique, then we how to write the polynomial. You will write f of a, and then you have f of b, and when you write the coefficient of f of a, you will miss a, so you have x minus b upon a minus b, and when you write the coefficient of f of b, you will miss b in the numerator, so you have x minus a upon b minus a. So this is the polynomial. And what is the error term? Here we have two data points, so n plus 1 is 2, so you have second derivative of f at r divided by 2 factorial x minus a, x minus b. So this much is the error, right? So exactly what you are doing is you are approximating your function fx as px n plus error. So you have exactly fx is equal to px plus error. So it means that you can just integrate this thing. So you have a to b f of x dx is equal to a to b px dx plus error integral a to b dx, right? Okay, this final, after integrating, we call it as error, that is in our trapezoidal rule. So you write down px. Px is simply this formula. So you have x minus b upon a minus b f of a plus x minus a upon b minus a f of b integral a to b. So what will be the integral? It will be x minus b squared by 2 a minus b f of a plus, you know how to integrate a polynomial, so this is x minus a square by 2 b minus a f of b a to b plus some error. Now you just put the limits a to b, you will get b minus a by 2 f a plus f b plus some error. Error we will compute later on. So you have this formula. This is an approximation to the integral, and you that formula is called trapezoidal rule. So you have trapezoidal rule as you can integrate your function a to b f of x dx. You can approximate this number as b minus a by 2 f of a plus f of b. So obviously that the first question that should come to your mind is why we call it as a trapezoidal rule. This is quite simple. If you look at the geometry, so this was your original function f of x, and you approximated your function with this straight line, and the straight line, this is the area which you are computing. This is b minus a, this length is b minus a, and this length, this first height is f of a, and this height is f of b. So area of this trapezoidal is b minus a by 2 f of a plus f of b. So area of a trapezoid is sum of the parallel sides, that is f of a plus f of b, into the height, height means distance between the parallel sides, divided by 2. This is how the area of the trapezoid is given, and this is nothing but we are replacing our function, our integral with this formula. That is why that is called a trapezoidal rule. So in this video we have derived a formula for trapezoidal rule which approximates the integral a to b f of x dx. In the next video we will compute the error and look at some example. Thank you.